guys, Blue Yoshi here, and welcome back to Super Mario Galaxy! Last time, we continued the garden and collected 5 stars in the Deep Dark Galaxy. Today, we are going to our final major galaxy! And this one is going to be the Melty Molten Galaxy. So, if you're excited for this episode of Super Mario Galaxy, please give this episode a like, share it with your friends, and comment if you have anything to say. So, let's go right into the garden here and start our 30th episode of Super Mario Galaxy. Alright, so as you can see, we did the Dreadnought Galaxy, we did the Deep Dark Galaxy. We do have another galaxy here, but that's going to be next episode. So, without further ado, let's fly to the Melty Molten Galaxy. Alright, let's do this right here. Okay, so, give me a second. Just trying to tone down the volume here. Not exactly the most amazing start of an episode, I must say, but, well, there is a lot of things I must say. So, if you are a loyal subscriber and have watched my videos a ton and actually pay attention to my channel, you may have noticed that this video is about 2 weeks late. Yeah, it kind of took a while, and I'm sorry. It's not like I tried to do that, people. It's kind of just a thing that happens, you see. First of all, I was sick for a majority of February, especially the early parts of February. I was very sick. So mainly I was just in the voice. And, you know, coughing and everything. And that wouldn't exactly work with the videos that I do. So, yeah, I kind of couldn't do videos then. And, after that, when I finally got better, we had about a single day between when I got better to vacation. And I couldn't exactly do editing on vacation because there was no internet, and there was problems overall. By the way, take note of this Hungry Luma right here, because, well, we're not going to do anything with him now. We will be doing him. Wow, okay. We're actually going to be giving him some starlets much later, but yeah. Keep in mind, he needs Eddie. Anyways, so, yeah, point is, I was sick, then I had to do a vacation. point is, I've been very busy, and it's not like I've tried to do this, so. Oh boy, okay. Okay, you gotta be really careful here. Just trying to show that there's a shortcut here, but. Okay. See, the thing that you wanna do here is you actually wanna let go, so that you can go forwards, but you can go down, by the way. Let's see, actually, if that will. Oh, okay, yeah. We're gonna go down, actually, because, I don't wanna die. It wouldn't be exactly very fun for me, but anyways. Back to the topic at hand. Yeah, so, that's the biggest thing that I've been concerned about lately. Plus, we have a lot of other things going on. Specifically, we are having a large doubles tournament at our church here shortly. So, you know, I've been having to plan that and all that. We have just, school things. I've been having a lot of homework lately. I've just had a ton of things I've had to worry about. So, it's not like I haven't tried to do these. It's just, life is life sometimes, but yeah, so that's why this video is extremely late, and I'm very sorry, but anyways, I really like this shot right here. It's just gorgeous to me. I don't know. I just think it looks really nice, but anyways, on to the upside down alien ship. Okay, so for this area, what you're gonna need to do here, you're gonna collect 5 star chips here to make a launch star here. So yeah, that's what you wanna do. That's what you're gonna do, what you gonna do? Man, that is such an old joke. Wow, okay, anyways. Yeah, let's go. You also have to watch out for all these fire bubbles, because there was a lot of them, and they may hit you if you're not careful, so you definitely want to be on the watch for that. But anyways, we are on a final planet here of our first mission in the Melty Molten Galaxy. So, let's see what it has in store for us. Wonderful things indeed. Yeah, I kind of... Oh my... Dude! Okay, that wasn't scripted or anything. That wasn't scripted or anything, but... I just realized, and it's not like this is the first time I've done this or anything, but I just realized that that is, like, scary. Like, to have that giant, like, perimeter around it. Just, like, I don't know. Anyways, you can go over there, by the way. I don't suggest you do because, you know, it kind of takes time away and you probably won't recover from it, but anyways. Grab that one up if you feel like it. Grab all these star bits. I'm not going to because I don't really need star bits just yet. It's going to be next episode. And I don't want to waste your time in this episode. So, anyways, that will be our first star today. So let's grab it. And that will be our first star of our final major galaxy in Super Mario Galaxy. Alright, let's go. As if we didn't have enough galaxies already. So, like, three times, well, it's quite amazing, I must say. Anyways, 94 stars. There was a total of, I believe, 120 stars in this game. So we are well on our way to finishing this game. In fact, I believe there's only going to be 6 or 7 more episodes, if you include this one or not. Yeah, of course, I've been planning all around that. A few of the later episodes will be having a ton of stars, mainly because I'm just trying to jam-pack it all in, but anyways, through the meteor storm we go. Alright, so, since there's not much to say about this, I have things to say myself. First of all, so today, I am, of course, doing this video, and today is right after the release of the Nintendo Switch. It is the 4th. Of course, I kind of couldn't record yesterday, so very sorry. But yeah, so today is the day after the release of the Nintendo Switch. So people may or may not be asking, what are you gonna do for Nintendo Switch? And believe me, I've been thinking about that. And it's not like I just, whatever. And if you've been listening to my recent episodes, specifically episodes 29 and 28, I have been talking about this, so I just want to elaborate. So, first of all, I don't have the funds to get it just yet. I am kind of out of money currently. I mean, like, not completely out of money, but I only have, like, few hundred dollars, and that's obviously not enough to get the Nintendo Switch, so... Yeah, I'm gonna have to save up for maybe a few months. I'm hoping that I can get it by probably April or May. So I'm aiming towards that time frame near the end of Blizzard 3, which is, you know, our tournament season coming up. So yeah, that's kind of the idea. I don't have to worry about how we're going to record it. I just have to worry about getting the system firsthand. Because the system uses the Elgato H260, which is what I'm using currently, to, you know, record it and everything. And, this thing, I have the Elgato H260. So, you know, I don't need to exactly worry about that. But, you know, I do have to worry about getting the actual system, because it's $300, and literally every store I've looked around, it's out of them. Of course, that will change in the coming months, so we'll just have to see, but... Yeah. Alright, let's go on to this planet. This planet is actually kind of interesting because you're gonna have to... You see all these fire bubbles? So you're gonna have to take them all out, surprisingly. When most of the time it doesn't really matter, it really does for this mission. So I highly suggest you do. Especially just the ones around the perimeter of this part. Those ones are all highly important. Anyways. Let's continue on. Again, just destroy all the fire bubbles that you can. So, yeah. Anyways, continuing what I was talking about the Nintendo Switch. So yes, if we're going to be doing anything on the Nintendo Switch, as one may guess, we're going to be doing Breath of the Wild, because why not? I also have plans to do Mario, but of course that will be coming out later, and well, I guess we'll just have to see what happens then, because again, I kind of don't have the funds to do any of that right now, so yeah, it's not going to happen now, or anytime soon, so yeah. So that's the Nintendo Switch for you. I know, it's sad that we can't do it on the first day, and I may just be doing something with my funds on it. Maybe we could go to someone else's house and they'll maybe do something on it. But it's not going to be a Let's Play or anything like that. No, instead, what we're going to do is, well, if we would do that, we would just, you know, play a game. So, anyways. Yeah, so, the other topic that I wanted to talk about is the Nintendo 3DS. So, at first you may be thinking, well, what is there to say about the 3DS? It's like, so old right now, and well, that's quite true, it's actually extremely old, I must say, but anyways, it's still relevant. And Pokemon Sun and Moon, you may have noticed, came out a while back in November. And I don't know if it's still relevant or not. I mean, I personally, like, haven't even played it yet. At least fully, you know, I've played like the first hour or so of the game, but not much. So, like, I hardly know anything about the game, and that's, you know, to preserve my blindness to everything. Looks really cool so far, and I've, of course, been wanting to do a Pokemon Let's Play for a while. In fact, the original idea was to get it done in December, or at least start it, but here's the thing! The recording hardware, I should say, never kinda came. In fact, I just got my recording hardware installed into my 3DS just like lately. So, well actually like I think a week ago I just got it. So it's not, yeah, I literally just got that. And I do have plans to use it. In fact, I have a lot of plans for it. You know, again, Pokemon Sun and Moon, we're going to be doing a three-way Let's Play of that, I believe, depending on how they want to deal with it. If they're actually going to post on their channels, or if we're going to do something with the Nintendudes. But I also have been kind of wanting to do other games. Like, I'm not sure, because the thing is, a Let's Play is so, it's very hard work. It's not something that you can just do on a whim. Oh, I like this game right now, so I'm just gonna do it. You have to be determined to get it all done. It's not something you can do on a whim again, so. Yeah, and that's, like, for example, the Super Mario Galaxy Let's Play. Well, it has been, obviously, my longest Let's Play, because it's been the only main Let's Play that I've done. Obviously, the thing is, if I really wanted to, I could do a Let's Play in much less than 2 years, what it's taken me to actually do this Let's Play. Thing is, you know, life exists. So, you know, how did I get hit by that? You know what? This is going to take me a while, and I don't want to waste your time, so cue the speedrun! We'll be right back. There we go! Oh my gosh, that took way too long. Oh boy, I'm sorry guys, because that was bad. Wow, okay, well, you see, now you understand why I dislike this course, you see. I just cannot stand this. Okay, so that will be a Lava Spiral Daredevil 1 out of the way. Pretty much the most difficult one that we have to do today. So, you know, you don't have to worry. The next one's not that difficult! But, yeah, so we have one main mission, and we have that secret mission back in the first star that we have to do. So, let's go defeat the fiery Dino Piranha. Now, if you remember back from, what was it, like episode 2? Yeah, I believe it's episode 2 that we actually fought Dino Piranha originally. Well, we didn't exactly have much problems with him. So, hopefully we don't have much problems with him this time. And boy, I'm just like 10 times as panicky whenever I go to these courses now. Like, I feel like I cannot afford to make a single mistake. Oh boy. Oh boy, okay. Oh shoot, I didn't mean to hit that, okay. Yeah, you can get a 1-up there. Again, 1-ups don't really matter in this game that much. Unless you're really having a problem with a certain mission, but aside from that, they don't have much purpose, so you can just bypass it if you want. Or you can, I don't know. Anyways, with these fire bubbles, I believe I've already demonstrated how to destroy these guys. Just need to lure them away from lava. Kick them. It's not that difficult. So yeah, for this time, instead of these little, what do you call them? Star chips. You're just gonna have to defeat all of these little lava bubbles. So, which feels really good to do genocide on these evil little jerks that killed me and wasted your time. I must say, it just feels so good. Yeah, anyways, if you're wondering what I was trying to say back there before I got wrecked by a bubble, I was just gonna talk about some Smash stuff. So, if you're wondering, March 17th is going to be when our next tournament is, and that's going to be a doubles tournament. As I said, it's going to be at our church at an overnighter, so now the thing is that the overnighters has age restrictions, so therefore a few of our players won't be able to play, most notably Micah, who, I don't know, if he had a good teammate this time, he may have actually got probably probably top 5 at least. You know, of course, we have a lot of people there at the church that are also going to be there that don't always come to a tournament, so I'm also excited for that because we're going to get new faces. We're going to see epic matchups that we have been waiting for such a long time. And, yeah. Plus, just the amazing size of our church is not to be underestimated. I think it's really lucky and really blessed to be able to be there. Anyways, church jokes aside, let's launch ourselves out of this launch stall to go over here. So yeah, now, aside from that doubles tournament, our next tournament after that is going to be our singles tournament, our Smash 4 singles. As I previously stated, we already had our Pokken Open, if you want to do it that way. I don't know, I don't have a preference. We did that, and that was a while back, actually. That was February 18th. So this next tournament will actually be exactly a month later, so. Again, it's an overnight, so it will be either on the 17th or the 18th, so. Who knows when we're gonna plan that, but anyways. Grab ourselves Life Shroom, get back to full life, let's blast off to fiery Dino Piranha. Alright, so here's how you deal with him. So fiery Dino Piranha, as you may have guessed, is fiery. His tail will sometimes be on fire, in which will hurt you if you touch it. But sometimes, in rare occasions, his tail won't be on fire. in which you can spin and attack him. That's essentially the gist of this battle. You have to be patient and wait for his tail to go out before you can smack it. He will also be full of lava, so it's not going to be fun if you hit him. So, yep. Anyways, I believe he only has... Yeah, this is final phase, actually. This is one quick battle. Yeah, for his final phase, he'll just be shooting out fireballs. And I think that's a little different, but anyways, oh boy, I thought his thing was still out, but I guessed wrong. Oh boy, okay, can't afford to make those mistakes again. Oh boy, okay, I am just having some problems here. Alright, get out of this way. There we go! That will be the end of Fiery Dino Piranha. Boom! He just disappeared. Just wham, it's gone. Just gone from existence. Again, I don't script these things, so that will be a fourth stone in this episode. You know, I just feel the need to do that, you know. Very vital to this episode's enticement. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore, but I'm sorry. But yeah. Also, I'm sorry that these videos are taking so long. Like, I know that's, like, for you guys, it's probably, like, what, 28 minutes? Somewhere around that mark. Like, currently I'm at 35 because I didn't speed up the footage yet. But, yeah, we don't talk about that. Anyways, so yeah, I'm sorry that these take so long. It's just the fact that we have to do 5 separate stars, and each star takes, you know, a few minutes to do. 5 minutes at the very least. So, like, by nature, each of these episodes are at least 25 minutes long. So, it is quite a long episode we're doing here, but whatnot, it's not going to be that common anymore, because this will be our final major galaxy, as I previously stated. So, this will be our final very, very long video. So, yeah, good for you guys. But yeah. Alright, let's keep on going over here, just get some star bits. Of course, we're going to need 80 star bits, I believe, by the time we get to that guy. Most of them will come from that volcano eruption, so we don't really have to worry about too much, but you do want to get all the star bits that you can, which is what exactly I'm doing. So yeah. Okay, so yeah. More about the Smash Singles Tournament. We do have some new rules. First of all, you know, 2 stocks, 6 minutes. We just increased the minute timer. There's no customs in 2017, if you're wondering. So that also goes for the doubles tournament. This is just to make it, you know, more simple and, you know, just not take as long to set off. And mainly just because, you know, other major national and regional tournaments, you know, they don't use that either. So, if they're not using it, why should we, you know? Anyways, I don't believe that's enough for us. Yeah, 75. Now, good thing here is that they were so generous as to actually give you some star bits over here if you're patient. So, this will be our way of getting to 80 here. Yep. And go to our final mission of our final major galaxy here. So,
hey, you! Yeah, you! Get any tasty star bits? If you feed me a bunch of star bits, I'll burst with snacky happiness and then transform! I'm famished, I need 80 star bits to curb the hunger pains. So hungry! More! Oh my!
I don't know what that was. Wow, okay. I didn't know my voice could go that high. I blame puberty. That was just... What the heck was that? I don't know. Anyways, back to the topic at hand. We have this final planet here, so let's go right here. Also, just finishing up what I had to say about the stage rules and, or just the rules in general. Aside from that, the stage rules are also changing. If you saw what the deal is with, you know, Evo and their change of stage rule set and everything, you'll be familiar with the idea. It is quite controversial right now on what, you know, rule set we should go by. I just personally like that new one because it makes it a whole ton simpler to explain to people when there's only 5 and not 8. And the thing is, like, with our tournaments, sometimes I have to explain to absolute noobs. You know, we're not a giant professional, you know, scene here, you know, because some of us are very competitive and very good at the game. But that doesn't exactly mean that everyone is exactly familiar with what we do. But anyways, so yeah, it makes it much simpler to explain, and I like that. So yeah. Anyways, that will be our 5th and final Silver Star, creating our final Star Heal in the Molten Galaxy. So let's quickly grab this. If we can't die, that would be, that'd be wonderful. Okay, just gotta be... I'm trying to think, where is that star? Is it over here or is it over there? I can't tell. Where is the star? Where is the star? I can't see. Oh, it's just over there. Okay. Alright, so let's grab it here. Wow, just barely missed that. Then that will be our final star in a major galaxy. Everyone, thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Comment if you have anything to say to me. And I will see you next time on Super Mario Galaxy. And I will see you then.